Jim Hennigan, retired Chicago Police Department detective, retired in 2009. Kenneth Hansen was twice tried and twice convicted of the murders of three boys who disappeared October, I believe, of 1955.
What took so long and how did they break that case?
They had two bomb and arson investigators who were working insurance fraud mostly on horse stables, barns and stuff, and they came across an informant that they knew, it was an FBI informant, Red Wimette.
Good evening, folks. This is Red Wimette coming back to you with a type of story.
And he had had some experience with Kenneth Hansen when he was younger.
When he mentioned Ken Hansen's name, I turned around and said, yeah, I know him. And he said, well, what's his claim for fame? And I told him, I said, well, I don't know. The guy turns around and he's kind of a strange guy. And he turned around and told me on that he murdered these three little boys, the Peterson boys, he called it. And that started the investigation right there.
So they're talking to him, and he says, you know, he told me once about killing these three boys. And then their hackles stood up, and they worked it from there, and they found four kids, basically, four guys who had come under Kenneth Hansen's thumb and were molested by him back in the 50s. And they each independently corroborated what Wimette was saying, that Kenneth Hansen had molested them and had told them, if you don't do what I say, you're going to end up like those three boys.
Why would you look at Hansen when it seems he's interested in boys and this is a case about girls?
He was married with kids. I don't think he was monosexual. I think it's a matter of power, a matter of having some control over somebody, and you know, whatever suits your fancy comes from that.
Also, could there be other people that Hansen was working with?
Yes.
Who were involved and may still be alive and may still be out there?
Yes. He was sort of connected with organized crime. His older brother, Kurt Hansen, was a thumper, a body guy for a number of people in organized crime. He was a guy that they would send out to send a message.